grade that you want and does your designs justice, okay, on a small scale. You know how the business works. You've been in there long enough to know that everything gets filtered down or ripped off in a lot of people's ways, is to rip yourself off and to make certain that a diffusion...
Everyone else is, so we might as well.
Look, otherwise you'll spend your whole life suing people instead of making shoes and making a bit of dough out of it, which is what you should be doing anyway.
The factory will take your prototype samples and then they will give that to whoever makes their lasts and their soles. I mean, particularly the 5-1, that's a huge investment for factory because that's, you know, a different mould, 5 different moulds, plus the wedge for every size, 4s to 8s. So that's a massive investment.
Their gamble is paid back when they start going into to multiple sales.
Right.
And obviously that's where you guys come in there and say, right, we would like to see it here, we'd like to put it into office. By then we'll have 40 stores and we can put some bulk behind it. If you've got an agent, we can then take it to Japan, take it around the rest of the world. That's where you sit and get a royalty for your original ideas at the top and hopefully work on the next stuff.
The only problem we've got with press at the moment is people love it. And we're getting loads of photo shoots, but the fashion editors are saying, but people can't get them anywhere.
Postmistress is opening up in Harvey Nichols in January.
Oh, brilliant. So
the first little opening. Will go in.
All right.
Higher price.
We want them in there. I'm sure you would like them in there.
Yeah, because these are spring, summer fixtures.
All we have to do is get them made. There's all there is
easy
to
seven
it.
Done.
That's right, yeah. Can you believe we had to cancel our wedding because we were too busy?
Yeah.
All of a sudden I got we had the wedding and then been for the 12th of September. That was great. That was really good. That's really cool. Thank you.
It's not what I expected at all. It's very good.
That's exactly the story. You want the small volume, top end. I mean, we've just been with him for 5 minutes and he's making shoes for anyone from Emma Bunton. He's done the Frost French show. He's in the press. Everything around this is quite incredible.
We had a lovely surprise this week.
Just as Terry and Liz were forgetting about the past, the editor of Pop magazine finally gets in touch.
We got a fax from Katie Grand, really nice fax from Katie Grand. I'm very sorry you feel sour about me and my magazine. I would very much like to make amends. Could we perhaps do a feature on you and your work in the next Pop, something substantial? It would transpire that she didn't realise they were Terry's shoes, because by all accounts there wasn't a label in them. And the whole thing with the Miu Miu thing, I really don't particularly want to get lawyers involved unless we absolutely have to, because it's...
Liz and Terry still cling to the hope of meeting the head of the Prada empire herself. They believe the well-connected Katie Grand can help them.
And maybe then what she can do is bring about the introduction between Terry and Lucia. Would be fabulous.
Terry is too much of a force in his own right to ever play second fiddle to a Prada or whoever.
I think that's exactly a suck it and see situation.
Yeah, I think it is too. I mean, we have to.
I mean, just
what we've said is that we'd like to talk to her.
He does need the mountain to come to Terry.
Terry and Liz have come to Elche on the Costa Blanca in Spain, a place famous for one thing.
This is Shoe City. I mean, the whole city became rich through shoes. Everyone here is in shoes. I mean, that's what they're in. They're in shoes.
Office have agreed to launch Terry's shoes in January.
You have to speak English and Spanish.
Now all he needs is to persuade a factory to invest a lot of their own money to produce his very expensive designs.
Creative department.
Right. Here we go.
The vintage shoes, when they're sort of second-hand shoes, are selling in auctions for many hundreds of pounds. And what we're trying to do is to do a new collection for the highest level of the market.
Su favorito.
Sí.
There are some deadlines here. We have to have production going through by the end of January, which means we need samples approved and sales samples effectively by the end of December. We have only a few weeks, 1 month. Yes. What's your feeling? We can achieve this. Yes. We can get
that. Yeah.
We can do it properly.
For the design is just gorgeous. It's brilliant.
Is it commercial?
Yeah, good. Really commercial.
For us, it's amazing to hear yes all the time instead of...
No, that's what we come to Spain for. It's the can-do attitude. That's what this town built itself on, being able to do what the market wanted and what customers wanted. Yes,
I love these guys. It's going to happen here, Chester. It's going to happen
here. Well, that's it.
Teddy is taken to see the nearby factory where his shoes will be made.
Blows me away. It does, it blows me away.
That's why you work with Elder. You come to Elder for the sophisticated handwork.
I love it. That's where I'm going to get my shoes made, Jess. They're all so good with their hands. You can just see. You can see them with their hands. All of them, look. They're all so deft. For 30 years, I've not had women that could do this. For 30 years, I've not had this. I used to have it when I first began. I love it.
In this town, they're very proud of their skills.
LT
is volume, really volume. Elder is smaller production. Yeah. It's traditional skilled shoemaking.
I want it. I want it now.
That's why we're here.
Yeah, no, exactly. Oh, I can work with these people.
It's just a whole sense of calm about the place, isn't there?
There is a sense of calm about the place, yes. Yeah. For a shoemaker, it's a city of dreams. It's all revolves around making shoes. We met the factory agent a week ago, and what he can do for us is all the things that we find so difficult to do. I'm not going to have to worry about so much of the crap that I've been worrying about. I'm certainly not going to be worrying about lawyers and court cases. I can just get on and do what I do best. I can design shoes. And simply as that, I can design shoes.
Delegation, I mean, we can delegate.
It means you can play to your strengths,
exactly.
You know, and let's face it, no one does Terry de Havilland the way I do Terry de Havilland.
It was rejuvenating as well. It was just like, oh, thank goodness.
It was a buzz, wasn't it?
Total buzz. It was almost like, why didn't we do this years ago? But, you know, we couldn't have done it years. It's serendipity. It's all happened at exactly the right time.
This is going to change everything. It's absolutely going to change everything. We felt it. We really felt that this was the change. The moment. The moment was here. Like, there were people there to help us.
I just can't wait to see you, after all these years, get the recognition that you should have had years ago. You know, I mean, you had, as far as I was concerned, a lot of people were concerned, Terry de Havilland had just disappeared. And to think that, you know, you finally have got this chance to come back and get the second shot at it, and the shot that, you know, you should be back where you belong. And I've got a funny feeling that Spain is going to enable you to get back to where you belong.
And Terry and Liz did finally manage to make the time to get married after all.
I am the rock and roll cobbler, and here we are rock and rolling in Harvey Nicks.
For the first time in 30 years, Terry de Havilland is back in the shops. Later this month, Terry's shoes will be marketed to exclusive shops from New York to Tokyo.
Thank you, darling.